Yes, yes.
Okay, so I'm going to try to complement your and Albert's points, which are extremely important and would probably be worth a full day seminars anyway, with a set of observations on collaboration models between pure academia and industry. I thought this was a particularly relevant topic to introduce in this panel, in extension to Joer and Albert's comments, because while this type of training networks purposely foster collaboration between industry and academia, and I think that's actually a very good thing, right? So I just wanted to kind of strengthen a little bit or give you my view, since Albert already mentioned that I've been in academia. I did my PhD in STM. I also did a three years postdoc in Ireland, and now I've been working in industry for 5 years now. So first, a disclaimer, this is my very personal view, and hopefully this can actually motivate a little bit of discussion as well, okay? Which I think is good. So I'm gonna start, so essentially what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna list a set of collaboration models that I have observed over my few years of experience in both academia and industry. And well, you can tell me afterwards in our roundtable discussion whether you agree or not, or whether, well, there may be models that fit better or not, right? So let's see if I can move on. Yeah. So I'm going to start with what I'm calling the GROM models. And I just want to make clear, they are not GROM because you are a researcher working in a university, and well, you do your own thing in the sense that you are trying to advance science without collaborating with industry, or the other way around, you are working in industry in a research lab and you are solving problems which are important for your company. Both things are fine, okay? What I'm considering GROM models is the choice of not collaborating between academic industry and industry based only upon a set of cliches that I think they're obviously wrong. So I just thought to include these models here that I'm perfectly sure you all agree they're wrong views or based on cliches that are really far-fetched from reality. The first one is kind of an observation that I have experienced among some people working in the industry, which see academics as people that are alien to reality. This happens sometimes. I think this is really wrong, right? So in this sense, if you're working in a research lab, you basically don't even contact academic institutions just because you decide on your own that, well, in academia, they don't have the view of your customers, they don't have the view of reality, and therefore they will not help you with your research, which I think is wrong. And it's a cliche that really rarely happens in my experience, at least. I found this kind of a little story from PhD Comics, which I'm pretty sure you all know about, which is in the sense an exaggeration of the view that some industrial people think of academics. And as I said, I think this is evidently wrong. But I've also experienced the other way around, right? Sometimes it happens that there are some academics that basically decide on purpose not to collaborate with the industry because, well, they think that industry, they're just solving engineering problems, they're not doing proper research, and therefore these people deliberately choose not to collaborate with industry because of the reason. And I think this is also wrong because, well, there are many research institutions that do proper research trying to advance science in addition to solving maybe more application problems which are relevant. An example is, of course, the classic example is Nokia Bell Labs, which is, I think, is also a partner organization of the project. Well, they have, as they are proudly owners of a series of Nobel Prizes, some of them are even pretty recent. So these are a clear example of a company that is actually advancing science, and therefore this view is evidently wrong. So moving on, I have identified a couple of other models, which, well, I don't think they're the ideal cases, and that's why they call it the meh models, in the sense that they're perfectly fine. They happen all the time. They're perfectly fine, but I think they are not ideal because, well, they don't exploit in full the potential that could be achieved between a proper collaboration between industry and academia. One view is essentially from academia seeing industry just as a problem generator. Okay, sometimes the most difficult part of a research is finding a problem to solve. Okay, I'm pretty sure you will You will all go through this at the beginning of your PhDs, right? And sometimes you see, okay, so we ask industry, they have plenty of problems to solve from their customers, and we use as a basis to actually solve problems on our own. Or we are doing, I don't know, machine learning, for example, and the obvious need from machine learning of big data is we need data. Typically industry companies have a ton of data, so we use them, we collaborate with them just because we need this data to do our own research, and therefore there is not real feedback loop between the two entities where you're doing your PhD or you're doing some research and you use just industry just to gather this data and write a paper, okay? This, as I said, this is a perfectly fine model. This works out, and I think it's perfectly fine, but I just believe it's not the ideal model because it doesn't exploit in full the potential of this collaboration. Of course, this works also in the other way around, right? Sometimes in industry, we have a problem to solve, with a very specific problem to solve. We just feel lazy about solving it, or we don't have the proper knowledge on how to solve the problem, and we go to academia and we ask for help, which is perfectly fine. As I said, we make a contract, we create a partnership, and we explain the problem, and academia helps us solve this problem and generate a solution for our customer or whatever problem you may have. And this may result or not also in a paper or a patent, which is fine. But as I said, it's also, I think, a scenario where it doesn't really exploit the potential that a proper collaboration between industry and academia may have, right? So I wanted to end with what I consider the IDEA model, which is really a feedback loop between the two entities, right? So there are advantages from industry and advantages from academia that it is hard to reach out without a proper collaboration between the two, okay? In industry, well, we have actual customers and we have also business units, which are kind of problem generators in the sense that we can have a view from them what may have an impact, at least at a short time, what may have an impact on your research, because, well, there are problems that are actually in need of being solved. On the other hand, in academia, there are opportunities that cannot be reached from industry, right? The most important, I think, is the ability of academia to actually reach out to other disciplines, like mathematics, physicists, typically in university, or professors and PhD students are in a campus where actually there are other departments with other disciplines which you can actually talk to and find out new ways of solving problems. It is amazing how often, and probably Joerg and Albert have way more experience than myself on this, it is amazing how often you talk to a physicist or a mathematician because you're trying to solve a problem, and turns out that a very similar problem, just in another context, has been solved in the past in some other field, okay? Just providing a proper context, it can be casted into solving your own problem. And also dissemination, right? I think from academia, it's easier to disseminate research, right? Going to conferences, talking to students, giving courses, giving lectures, or even giving this kind of panels in training networks like this one, right? And I think a proper feedback loop between these two, taking advantage of the advantages that each of the sites have, only by doing this properly in a continuously feedback manner, you can actually have way more impact. So not only creating a patent, not only creating just a single paper because you have the data for it, but actually creating a series of papers, solving a series of problems, creating a series of patents, building prototypes and demonstrators, and ultimately even delivering an actual products and services which may have an impact in industry. So I think by doing this proper collaboration, which I think this type of training networks like ENLIGHT'EM has fostered and make this possible, you can create an actual impact on research. And this is all I got. So maybe, hopefully, this actually fosters a little bit of discussion as well.